Yesterday, I played a game of cards. While playing this game of cards, the thought came to me: how many times would you have to shuffle a deck of cards before the cards actually got mixed up? So I devised this experiment.
You take a deck of cards, all 52 of them in order. Then you shuffle them one time. When you do this, you lay the cards flat out like this. After this, you count how many uninterrupted sequences of cards there are still in order. And they both have to be the same suit. Both me and my team repeated the sequence of shuffling, laying them out, counting, shuffling, laying them out, counting, over and over again, about 32 times each. Here's a picture of my findings. As you can see, by the first shuffle, there were only 32 cards still left in order. But by the 27th shuffle, there were no more cards left in order. It continued like this until we were done. The average amount of cards still left in order was
9.21
cards. The lowest we got was, of course, 0, and the highest we got was, of course, 52. It was interesting to me that here, on number 7, it goes from 18, then jumps back on 8 up to 24. It did this a couple other times, but this one was the biggest jump.
So, what have we learned from this? Well, in the time that we did this experiment, we learned what the best strategy to shuffling cards is. You want to shuffle cards like this. When you do that, you want to do that at least 29 times to get a nice, even shuffle, to make sure that there are no cards that could potentially mess up your game. To me, Kyron, and Henry, the biggest takeaway that we took from this experience was the scientific method. From coming up with a question, creating a hypothesis, doing an experiment, just the fun of doing that is the biggest experience we're going to take with us into our lives.